Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2315, an occasional spill due to volatile size. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a great question sent in by Dave, and this question came up twice this week. I'm going to build a simple little formula here, equal RAND between, and generate a numbers between 4 and 10. And then down here, a new dynamic array, equal RAND array. How many rows do I want? I want whatever's answer is up there in A1. How many columns? 4. Let's just use something between 11 and 19. And integer, sure, why not? Okay, now when I press enter, I get an answer, right? So there's 6 here. It gave me 6 rows. Then I'm going to come out here to the formulas tab and I'm going to calculate. It works. It works. It works. Calculate again, calculate again, calculate again, calculate again, calculate again. Ah, a spill error. What the heck? How did it keep working and then all of a sudden stops working? I actually have the opposite question for Dave is, why is it working at all? Because this is against the rules. I'll put a link to this support article down in the YouTube comments, but basically here's what it says. Excel is unable to determine the size of the spilled array because it's volatile and resizes between calculation passes. Dynamic array resizes may trigger additional calculation passes to ensure the spreadsheet is fully calculated. If the size of the array continues to change during these additional passes and does not stabilize, Excel will resolve the dynamic array as spill. Now, you're allowed to use things like offset, indirect, and today because they don't change values on every calculation pass. If this was true, I hate to argue with Microsoft, actually, I'd love to argue with Microsoft. If this was true, that thing would be recalculating every single time. Every time I press calc now, we should be getting the spill error. So it's super frustrating that it works, what, 90% of the time? And then all of a sudden fails. Like, why is it working most of the time, Joe McDade? That's the great question. So honestly, I never tried this. I read early on, you're not allowed to do this. So I never did it. But a few people have been doing it, seeing it works really good, and then bam. Anyway, so known issue, can't do it. It's covered in the book, Excel Dynamic Arrays, straight to the point. Click that I on the top right hand corner. And hey, if you enjoy these tips, please click the subscribe button and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the comments below. I want to thank Dave for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.